Here at Wolf TV, we are privileged to learn on the traditional and unceded territories of the Catesy, Kwantlen, Semiamu, and other Coast Salish nations.
Let's talk about what's happening in the world. A few weeks ago, a Muslim woman in Austria was harassed in public and had her hijab pulled off and no one around them decided to help. This shows that many individuals still lack the knowledge and respect of other people's beliefs and values. No person should be disrespected and assaulted for the color of their skin, their gender, or their beliefs. If you see anyone being mistreated, make sure to take a stand. Be the reason the world becomes a better place.
And here we are with our latest sports update.
Did you know that the women's national hockey team won against their host Finland 4-2? Oh my gosh, right?
The Canucks, on the other hand, haven't...
No, we don't talk about that.
Peace, quiet, and mindfulness. The Mindfulness Club runs on Mondays during lunch in the Lower Yellow Pod in Mr. Bilingus' room. And if you're looking for a quiet place to chill, there are a bunch of activities for you to do at the Mindfulness Club. So join the club if you're interested.
Hi, I'm Amanda.
And I'm Paige.
And we're the leaders of the Pawprint Newsletter and Writing Club.
The Pawprint is a student-run newsletter which showcases creative writing skills.
And we also focus on events, creating events such as writing contests and writers' cafes.
We meet every Friday at lunch
in Lower Green, so come join us.
Now here we have Omar Kamis, leader of Model UN. What does the lunch look like at Model UN?
Every Tuesday at lunch, we hold meetings covering different aspects of Model UN. So for example, this week we talked about the flow of debate and what goes on. So every week we'll be learning something new about Model UN, which will lead us up to going to a conference.
And how many members are in Model UN?
There are 30 members inside of Model UN, including myself and the vice president.
And where and how can people join Model UN?
You can join Model UN by coming to the Lower Yellow Pod during a lunch on Tuesday or messaging Mr. Bilinga or myself on Teams.
Hello, my name is Hannah.
My name is Kieran.
And today we're going to be playing a French spelling game.
Okay, I'm going to show you a French word and you're going to have to pronounce it.
Okay.
Livre?
Same thing.
Pretty close, yes. I give you like a 7 out of 10.
Damn. Okay, hello. I'm going to show you a French word and you're going to try to pronounce it.
Oh, okay.
Yes, so here's the word.
Fleur?
Yes, that's correct. That is a 10 out of 10. Good job.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to show you a French word and you're going to try and pronounce it.
Okay. All right, I got you. Voiture.
Voiture.
Vite. Okay, well, you got it right. You two were kind of close, but not really.
I got it right?
No.
I got it right?
Yes.
Hello, I'm going to show you a French word, and you're going to try to pronounce it.
Oh, okay.
So, okay. So how are you feeling going into this confidence level?
I am feeling really confident, over the moon. I think I'm going to kill it.
I have no confidence. I'm awful at languages.
I'm going to get it because I did French.
Oh, right. I forgot about that. Okay. Anyways, so here's the word. Here's the word. Okay. Attempt.
Phrase.
Okay.
Phrase.
Phrase.
That's a phrase.
Okay. So the first one is right. That's a 10 out of 10. And these are good attempts as well. I'm going to say 7 out of 10.
I know
how
to speak French.
Yeah,
I got it right.
I told you I'm French.
Here's a fun, eco-friendly fact. Surrey is now implementing a complete plastic bag ban. That also includes styrofoam takeout containers. Next time you're shopping, try to use reusable or paper bags when you're bringing your groceries home. Any plastic bags you have at home can be recycled at certain stores. Do your part to help the environment.
Fashion, one of the top 5 polluters in the world. It causes about 300,000 tons of pollution a year. One solution is shopping sustainably. By buying less clothing and extending the life cycle of your current clothes, donating to thrift stores, shopping from thrift stores or secondhand clothing stores like Poshmark or Refash, shopping with tote bags to avoid using disposable bags, researching the companies you're shopping from, and rent in outfits for special occasions when you can. By shopping sustainably, you're supporting the planet by reducing carbon emissions, waste, and water pollution. Plus, you look good doing so.
Joining us today, we have Marco and Andy. So you guys came here, or came to Canada in August, correct?
Yeah.
What is something that you find different between Spain and Canada?
Well, people are nicer here.
Okay. Yeah, all things are very different, and here in the school, it's much different, much like less difficult, but kind of more interesting.
Okay, I see. And what has your experience been like leaving home and living with a different family?
It's difficult adapting to a new family. Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't know how to describe it.
It's like your first time leaving home, okay? And then Marco?
Yeah, more or less the same. It's difficult, but I think all the families are very good here. So it's difficult, but it's more or less easy to adapt here.
Okay, I see. And then I have a question for Andy first. What is something in Canada that you wish was in Spain? So it could be people, the weather, food, anything.
I don't really know. I wish people were nicer in Spain and more open-minded as here.
Okay.
And for example, our schools are more about studying, and here it's more about practicing and developing, like improving as a person. Right, so I wish that we had the kind of schools system in Spain.
Similar school system.
Yeah.
Okay, and then Marco, what is something in Spain that you wish was in Canada?
Maybe the weather in Spain is much better than
the
here.
Weather, it's much hotter, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, that's all my questions. Thank you.
Tons of people use the rainbow flag to represent the LGBTQ community. But did you know the well-known rainbow flag is just one of many that people in the community connect with? Different groups, genders, and identities have come up with their own flags over the years to bring awareness to their unique needs and experiences. In 1978, artist Gilbert Baker created an official pride flag. Each color has specific meaning or symbolism. For example, blue means harmony. Orange is for healing, and green symbolizes nature. Pink and turquoise are expensive colors to print, so the pink and turquoise from Gilbert's original creation were removed so that the flag would be easier to mass produce. This is the version of Gilbert flags you might see today. Other versions also exist, like the inclusive LGBTQ flag. This flag with brown and black was created in 2017 to give representation to black and brown people in the LGBTQ community and the unique challenge they face. For example, black LGBTQ people likely experience struggles from homophobia and from racism in society. The Progress Pride flag combines the colors and stripes from the inclusive flag and the colors of the transgender pride flag. There are many other pride flags, each with their own special meaning. We encourage you to get to know what some of the flags mean. Maybe you will find one that connects to your gender identity or sexual orientation.